new version of the old hunting knife is in the final stages of planning in Mobile. Joe Newman, who calls himself a self-taught physicist and is an inventor, has patented and soon will be marketing the new knife. Newman maintains that the knife will be a valuable aid to hunters and to the military. The knife, in different sizes, ranges in weights of from 1.5 pounds for the large to 0.75 pounds for the smaller model. It is made from 1080 high-carbon steel, and it meets military specification.
We call it the Magnum knife, Jim. It's so designed that when an individual throws it, he doesn't have to be concerned whether or not it's going to land on a point, but so whether or not it's going to hit the target. I feel like this is really the first innovation that's been made in a knife in probably 10,000 years, other than your improvement in temper of steel. Any other conventional knife that you normally buy, you can't really do any more with it than a caveman did with a sharp bone or stone. Then you had a better cutting edge. This knife is so designed that no matter how you throw it, it lands point forward. It's got more momentum than a bullet fired from a 30-30 rifle.
Well, exactly. Now, how is it constructed? I noticed the ball is probably the most noticeable change from a conventional knife.
The ball plays a very big part in the function of the knife. It acts as an impact member to drive this blade forward when it's thrown. Also, it acts as a holding member, so when an individual throws it, he throws it like throwing a baseball. Anything he can hit with a baseball, he can hit with this knife when he practices. Also, the knife acts as an improved hand guard, so it distributes the pressure when a man's thrusting his knife 360 degrees around his hand.
Saves quite a few bruises.
Oh, yes, tremendous amount.
Well, now, about the fins on the back, this is something else that's new. How does this operate?
The fins are so designed so aerodynamically it stabilizes the unit when it is thrown. Normally, when they're not being thrown, the fins telescope down in the handle, so they aren't in the way when a man's going cutting, skinning, or any other conventional means of they use a regular knife. He gets ready to throw it, the fins pop out, and he's then able to throw the knife quite accurately. And he gets through with it, again, he telescopes the fins back into his handle.
What about this arrowhead feature that's on the front?
This is so when a man is hunting that he can take this arrowhead and place it on the knife. You have a four-way cutting edge.
Mm-hmm.
It improves the hemorrhage ability when the knife is going into a game, and its recovery of the animal is increased considerably.
Well, as the inventor of this now, what do you plan to do with it?
We plan on trying to get on the market this fall. The Army has shown a big interest in it already. They're waiting for finished samples. We hope by the 1st of November to have this on the market nationwide.
Approximately, what would this sell for?
It'll, depending on the size, the smallest one retail for $29.95 up to $34.95 for the largest model.